All right, the president now weighing in after the resignation from Rob Porter and now David Sorensen, the second White House official, as it relates to domestic abuse allegations. The president here has tweeted, "People's lives are being shattered and destroyed by a mere allegation. Some are true and some are false. Some are old and some are new. There is no recovery for someone falsely accused. Life and career are gone. Is there no such thing any longer as due process?"
And the argument could be made that due process was made in regards to Rob Porter. The FBI talked to both of the ex-wives. One of the ex-wives, Jennifer Willoughby, had filed a criminal complaint with police. The FBI told the White House there was these were credible sources, that there was credible information that this had happened. And the White House still chose to keep Rob Porter on board.
That's the point, is that this is the process.
This is the process. This is due process. And the fact is, again, in this tweet this morning, no mention of the women.
No mention of the women.
I mean, you want to talk about somebody's life who is ruined. You can talk to a lot of women who are strong enough and open enough to talk about it, like Jennifer Willoughby did.
Yeah. And on your screen,
right, it changes everything.
Right now, this is the pattern, obviously, of the alleged assaulters and abusers that the White House has defended, most recently with Rob Porter, Roy Moore in Alabama, and those allegations of child molestation, allegations against Steve Bannon of domestic violence, and, of course, the allegations of Roger Ailes and Bill O'Reilly of Fox News of sexual improprieties and advances. And, of course, the largest picture in the center is the president himself, who has been accused of sexual advances, unwanted advances to more than a dozen women.